Hello everyone, hope all of you are safe. Let me introduce myself. This is Lopamudra Deb. My educational qualification is MSc MET and I have almost 11 years of teaching experience in junior college, secondary schools and also in B.Ed. college. At this adverse situation of COVID-19 pandemic, I think most of you want to be safer at home. At the same time, you have many aspirations that you want to fulfill. So among that, some of you want to be teacher, some of you want to aspire to be teacher, and for that B.Ed. course has become compulsory nowadays. So through this video I want to provide you some guidance regarding the B.Ed. course. In future, I'll be uploading about the various papers. So as it is the first video, that's why I want to discuss something about the syllabus of Guwahati University B.Ed. course. So we have total 14 papers and the B.Ed. course is of 2 years. That means each paper you will be having seven papers. First year 7 papers and then in second year 7 more papers you will get. So in this video I'll discuss mainly about the syllabus of first year. Okay, in the first year you have 8 papers and some papers, most of the papers, marks allotment for most of the papers are 100, 80 marks for external or written exam and 20 marks for internal or assignment or practicum. So in the first year you have, as I said, already said, you have 7 papers. In first paper, the name of the paper is developmental psychology. Here you will get to know about the process of development, various stages of development, various types of development, personality of the children. Because if you want to be a successful teacher, you must have knowledge about all this so that you can properly deal with the children in the school. Okay, this paper contains total 100 marks, 80 for the external or written exam and 20 for the internal or practical. Then you have paper 2 named Contemporary Concern and Issues in Indian Education. Here you will be provided knowledge about various committees, commissions, various stages of education. You will get to know about book selection committee. You will get to know about privatization, globalization of education, about some current social scenario, how they influence the educational system. You will get to know about the importance of peace education. All these things are there in this paper. Okay, this paper also contain total 100 marks, 80 for written and then 20 for internal practicum exam. Then you have paper 3, this is teaching approaches and strategies. So there is a very important characteristic of a good teacher, that is having mastery over the subject. So it's not sufficient to be having appropriate or sufficient knowledge about the subject. You must have the knowledge. How should you implement your knowledge? How should you transmit your knowledge to the children? For that you need to apply proper strategies, techniques of teaching in the classroom. So in this paper you will be getting to know about the maxims of teaching, different strategies, styles, techniques of teaching. All these ideas you will get in this paper. Like earlier 2 papers, this paper also contain total 100 marks, 80 for the external or the written exam and 20 for the internal or the practical. Next you have paper 4 which is named as language and curriculum transaction. That means how you should transmit the curriculum to the children. How should you, to benefit the children, how the curriculum transaction is done in the school. So here it is total 50 marks. Remember, your fourth paper contain total 50 marks, 40 for the written and 10 for the internal. That means 40 external and 10 for internal. Next you have paper 5, which is named as Foundation of Education. Here you will be provided knowledge about psychological, social and physiological foundation of education. Okay, by getting those ideas, it will be very easier for you to make your teaching effective when you will enter into the real world of teaching. Here also you will have total 100 marks in this paper, 80 marks for the external or written exam and 20 for the internal. Now paper 6, you need to be very careful about that. Here in the paper 6, the name of the paper is Pedagogy of School Subjects. Okay, that means different subjects are there in the school and you cannot apply same strategy, same technique, same ways of teaching for all the subjects. That is that in such case your teaching cannot be effective. So you need to, here in this paper you will be given idea about the subject, what kind of technique and methods you should apply. Okay, here two groups of subjects you will get. Each group contain 4 subjects. You need to choose any one of them. That means don't confuse one subject from each group. That means 2 subjects from 2 groups you will have to choose. Okay, in the first group you will be having teaching of MIL. So Guwahati University's syllabus, you will get Assamese, Bengali, Hindi and Boro. And then you have teaching of English, teaching of science and teaching of history. These are the subjects of first group. Here among these subjects you need to choose only one. Then in the second group, again you will have 4 subjects. These are social science, mathematics, geography and Sanskrit. Among these 4 subjects, again you need to choose one. Okay, this paper, that means for each group the marks allotted are 50, 40 for written and 10 for the practicum. So total, if you take both the groups, in that case it will be 100, 50 from each group. Okay, then you have paper 7. Okay, that is first is EPC 1. Okay, here practice teaching. In the first year you will be sent to the school for 1 month. You will have to teach in the school 1 month. You need to attend the school on a regular basis, and at the end of the practice teaching you will be assessed by external. Some external will be invited or sent by the Guwahati University to assess your teaching, whether you are implementing all the techniques or whether you are implementing whatever knowledge you have got in this whole year properly or not. That will be assessed by the external. Okay, then you have EPC 2. Here drama and art in education. The earlier practice teaching also you will be having 100 marks, 50 lesson plan also you will have to submit. At the same time for practical and viva you will be given marks. So total 500 marks will be given. Then in the EPC 2 you have drama and art in education. There also you will have to attend some workshop in this workshops in the school college that will be arranged by the college authority. At the same time, Viva exams will be there. So total 100 marks are there in this paper. For this paper, you need to submit some handicrafts also you need to submit. So there are also marks are allotted for that. So each and everything you need to be very very careful about, so that you cannot successfully, you not only successfully complete the B.Ed course, but also become very very successful in the world of teaching. Okay, then EPC 3, here ICT is there, that means information and communication technology, because we have entered into the world of technology. We need to be very very enriched with the various technological approaches, so that we can make our children also to be acquainted with the technology. So in future, to make the children very very successful in all the fields, we need to make them knowledgeous about various communication technology. Here also you will be having 100 marks. You will be some practical exams you will have to give. You will be assessed by the external through Viva also. So total 100 marks. So first paper you will be having 80 marks, second paper also 80, third paper is also of 80 marks, fourth paper you are having 50 marks, then fifth paper again 100, sixth paper total 100, each group 50 marks, then seventh paper practice teaching 100 marks, EPC 2 that is drama and art in education 100 marks, and EPC 3 ICT and classroom transaction again 100 marks. So total you will be having 700 marks, 440 for external or written exam, 110 for the internal exam, and then whatever Viva and practical exams will be there for paper 7, 3 groups, EPC 1, EPC 2 and EPC 3, you will be having 150 marks. So total in first year you will have to appear for papers of total 700 marks. Okay, so as this is my first video, I am not going to make it too large, that's why I want to end today's discussion here. Hope you have liked the video. If you have really liked the video, you do subscribe my channel, like the video to encourage me, and if you want any kind of improvement, please do let me know in the comment box. Hope this video will be beneficial for you. So let me end up the video here with the hope of great success of mine and you all as well. So bye for now.